the grid computing subject. So in this, we having there some contents, that is evaluation of SOA and introduction to grid architecture and standards, elements of grid computing and grid architecture. So these are the different things we are going to explain in this topic. Okay, ma. One second, ma. So okay ma, coming to the evaluation of software as a service, SOA service. So in this evaluation, oriented architecture, software oriented architecture. Sorry ma, software oriented architecture, SOA, has evolved over the years. So SOA applies the building grids, clouds, grids of clouds, clouds of, so coming to this ma, so are you able to hear my voice ma? So coming to this ma, software as a software service oriented architecture has evolved over the years. Okay, so many years we are going to develop this, from so many years to we are going to develop this software service oriented architecture. So SOA is applies the building grids, clouds, grids of clouds, clouds of grids, clouds of clouds. These are also known as inter clouds and systems of the systems in general. So it means what ma? So service oriented architecture anedi so many years nunchi developing lo undi. Service oriented architecture, this is service oriented architecture applies for building the grids, clouds, so grids, clouds, grids of clouds, clouds of grids, clouds of clouds. So in order to build that, we are using the service oriented architecture. Service oriented architecture is nothing but it provides the service to the grids, clouds, grids of clouds, clouds of grids, and clouds to clouds. So this is, we can also say it is a intra clouds and system of systems in general. So a large number of sensors provide data. A large number of sensors provides the data, that is collection services, denoted as SSS, sensor service. So what we are denoting ma? Sensor services. So the large number of sensors provide data collection services, that is denoted as a sensor service, that is in shortcut SS. A sensor can be a Zigbee device, a Bluetooth device, a Wi-Fi access point, a personal computer or GPA or a wireless phone, among other things. So these are comes under the sensor services. So what is the sensor services ma? Zigbee devices, a Bluetooth devices, a Wi-Fi access point, a personal computer, a GPA, and or a wireless phone, among other things. These are comes under some sensor services. So a large number of sensors provide the collection of services, denoted as sensor service. Okay na? So the Bluetooth, the raw data is, so that if this is the architecture of the service oriented architecture. Okay, so the raw data is collected by sensor network. The raw data is collected the sensor network, collected the sensor services. The raw data is nothing but it collects the sensor services. All the SS devices interact with a large or small computers. So whatever the sensor services we have discussed now, so what are the sensor services ma? Zigbee device, Bluetooth device, Wi-Fi access point, personal computers, GPA, wireless phones. These are the sensor services. So these are interacted with the large or small computers. Many form of grids, database, and the compute cloud and storage cloud and filter cloud, the discovery cloud, and so on. So what are the small computers ma? It can be interacted with, so whatever the sensor devices we are talking about, that those are interacted with these type of things, like computers, clouds, many forms of grids, database and compute cloud, the storage cloud, filter cloud, discovery cloud. These are the different types of devices which is interacted with. These sensor devices are interacted. So these are the different types of devices which is interacted with that. So filter services, FS. What is mean by filter service? FS. So in this we are having everything. If you see the diagram, in this diagram we are having the FS. So wherever you are seeing, there is our FS. FS is a filter service. So whatever the service you are giving to that, the service is filter in that. Okay, na? SS is in the boxes. If you see the surrounding of this boundary, surrounding of this, we are having SS. Okay, na? This is the sensor services. FS is the filter service. So sensor services will be provide the service. So that service taken by the FS. FS is the whatever the filter service. That whatever the service they have taken, that will be filtered. So filter cloud, we are seeing here, filter cloud, storage cloud, and compute cloud. These are the different types of clouds we are having. Another grid, another service, another grid database. These are taking the services, and whatever the services they have taken, that is filtered in the cloud. Okay, na? Everything is filtered in the cloud. So okay, na? So FS is a filter service are used to eliminate unwanted raw data. So whatever the data we are not using, the data is eliminated by the filter service, and whatever the things they are using, they are filtered in the cloud. That is the filter service. And in order to respond a specific request from the web, the grid, and the web services, a collection of filter services forms a filter cloud. So what I'm saying, so whatever the information you are taking from the devices, that can be filtered in the filter cloud. Okay, na? Filter cloud, and the filter services will be filtered in the information will be filtered in the cloud. So unwanted raw data will be deleted, and in order to respond that, we specific request from the web. Okay, na? So a collection of filter services forms a filter cloud. So whatever the collection of services, so FS, meer ikkada correct ga observe chesthe image lo manaki ekkadaithe box rectangular shapes lo chi FS anedi undi. So a collection of FS ni em antarante filters cloud antam. Oka filter cloud, collection of filter services is called filter cloud. Okay, na? FS filter services forms a filter cloud. So we will cover the various clouds of compute. We can cover the various cloud of compute storage. Okay, na? We can cover the various clouds of compute storage, filter, and discovery. This is the compute cloud, storage cloud. These are we are covering. These things are we are going to cover. So what is that? A collection of filter service forms a filter cloud. Okay, na? So a group of filter services teeskunte oka filter cloud ani calculate chestam. Okay, na? So filter services covers all the various clouds for compute storage. Ikkada chuste compute undi kinda chudanma diagram lo compute cloud, storage cloud, ee things nannitni cover chestund anamata. Okay, na? This filters cloud anedi. Okay, na? And discovery, these things are covered by this filter cloud. And the various grids, P2P networks, and IoTs, we are discussed in the latter chapters. So we are going to see this image. In this image we are having there different services, that is filter service and sensor services. These are taken the informations and stored in the filter cloud. Okay, na? So this is the service oriented architecture. So the processing this data will generate useful information. So when we are processing these things of data, will generate a useful information, and subsequently the knowledge for all the daily user. So whatever the information ma meeru normal ga chusukunte meeru cloud, whatever the information, gmail ankonde, gmail anedi kuda oka cloud lantide. Cloud lo ne meeru data store chestunnaru, mee gmail lo meeku kavalsina information anta dantlo store chestaru data. ఫైల్స్ అని మీ ఇమేజెస్ అని వీడియోస్ అని అన్నీ మీరు మెయిల్లో స్టోర్ చేస్తారు. ఎందుకు? ఇట్ విల్ బి కీప్ సేఫ్, ఓకే, సేఫ్గా ఉంచుతాయని. ఎప్పుడైనా మీకు యూస్ఫుల్ అయితే చూసుకుంటారు, స్టడీ చేసుకుంటారు, గ్యాదర్ చేసుకుంటారు. సో ఏదైనా డేటా మీ మెయిల్లో కాకుండా లేని ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ని గ్యాదర్ చేయాలి అనుకుంటే మీరు ఇంటర్నెట్ యూస్ చేస్తారు. సో ఇంటర్నెట్ ద్వారా ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ని గ్యాదర్ చేస్తారు. సో అదంతా ఇంటర్నెట్ అంటే ఏంటి? క్లౌడ్లో ఉన్న ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ని మీరు తీసుకుంటున్నారు. వాట్ ఎవర్ ద డేటా యూ వాంట్, యూ విల్ బీ యాక్సెస్ దట్ డేటా త్రూ ద ఇంటర్నెట్. సో ఏ డేటా కావాలనుకుంటే ఆ డేటా మీరు డైలీ మీరు నెట్ ద్వారా ఆ డేటాని యాక్సెస్ చేస్తున్నారు, ఓకేనా? సో అలాంటి ఫెసిలిటీస్ అనేది మనకి దాన్ని ఏమంటారు అంటే సర్వీస్ ఓరియంటెడ్ అంటాం. సర్వీస్ అనేది మనం గెయిన్ చేసుకుంటున్నాం, మనం సర్వీస్ తీసుకుంటున్నాము, సర్వీస్ ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తున్నాం, రెండు టూ థింగ్స్ అనేది జరుగుతుంది ఇక్కడ. సో దాని సర్వీస్ ఓరియంటెడ్ ఆర్కిటెక్చర్ ఇమేజ్ ఇది, ఓకేనా? ఇవన్నీ ఏంటంటే సర్వీస్ సెన్సార్ సిస్టమ్స్ అంటే త్రూ సెన్సార్స్ ద్వారా కూడా మనం డేటా యాక్సెస్ చేయాలి. వైర్లెస్, ఇప్పుడు నేను సిస్టమ్ యూజ్ చేస్తున్నాను, ఇంటర్నెట్ యూజ్ చేస్తున్నాను, దీని ద్వారా కేబుల్స్ ఉన్నాయి. అదే నేను మొబైల్ ద్వారా డేటాని యాక్సెస్ చేస్తున్నాను అంటే దట్ ఈస్ వైర్లెస్. సో సెన్సార్ అంటే ఏదైనా కావచ్చు. సెన్సార్ అంటే బ్లూటూత్, వైఫై అండ్ వేరియస్ థింగ్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రీవియస్ మా జిగ్బీ డివైజెస్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ జిపిఏ, పర్సనల్ కంప్యూటర్స్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ థింగ్స్ వీ క్యాన్ యాక్సెస్ ద ఇంటర్నెట్. దీస్ ఆర్ ద వైర్లెస్, ఓకేనా? సో సెన్సార్ వీ క్యాన్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ సెన్సార్ డివైజెస్, సెన్సార్ సిస్టమ్స్. వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ప్రొవైడ్ ద సర్వీస్ త్రూ దట్ వీ క్యాన్ యాక్సెస్ ద సర్వీస్ ఆల్సో అండ్ వీ క్యాన్ ప్రొవైడ్ సర్వీసెస్ ఆల్సో. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ద సర్వీసెస్ వీ ఆర్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ దట్ క్యాన్ బి టేకెన్ బై ది ఫిల్టర్ సర్వీసెస్. ద ఫిల్టర్ సర్వీసెస్ విల్ బి చెక్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద నెసెసరీ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ దే నీ, దే విల్ బి ఫిల్టర్ దట్ అండ్ రా డేటా విల్ బి, అంటే వేస్ట్ రా ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ వేస్ట్ డేటా, ద వేస్ట్ డేటా విల్ బి ఎలిమినేటెడ్. అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ ద వర్కింగ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సర్వీస్ ఓరియంటెడ్ ఆర్కిటెక్చర్. ద మోస్ట్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటెడ్ wisdom or intelligence is started in a large knowledge basis. So we can intelligently, we have take the decisions based on the biological machine wisdom. Readers will see in this structure clearly. Okay, na? So most distributed systems require say web interfaces or portal. So most distributed systems and data, whatever the information we are going to distribute, information means files, data. So we are distributing through a through the web interfaces or portal. The raw data collected by a large number of sensors, to be transformed into useful information or knowledge. The data stream may go through sequence of compute, storage, filter and discovery clouds, okay na? So what I told that whatever the here we are having storage cloud, compute cloud, okay, discovery. So these are things, these are the sensors. So these are the sensors. The data stream may be go through sequence of compute, storage, discovery and this like discovery, okay. These all things we can say inter service messages. These are things we can say, see here having the dark arrow line, black color. So these are called the inter service messages. So here we are having discovery cloud and here we are having storage cloud and compute. These are things works through the sequence. In the sequence process it will be work, okay. Finally the inter service messages converge or the portal. So if you see that inter service message, upper we having portal in the oval shape, so portal, okay na, which is accessed by all users. See, upper we are having computer, laptop, mobile, these are the users. They will access the information from this portal. So from this portal they will provide the services, they will access the services, okay na? This is called the portal. The user will be access this information from the service oriented architecture. Finally the two examples we are having, portal OGFCE and Hub Zero, and are described in latter section. So now we are using both web services, portlet and web 2.0 gadget technologies. Many distributed programming models are also built on top of these basic constructs. So this is called the complete working of the service oriented architecture. Now we are going to discuss about the grids versus clouds. Now coming to the boundary between grid and clouds are getting blurred. So the boundary between grid and cloud are getting blurred in recent years. So already I told this point in the previous class. So these two, grid and cloud, will be become very blurred because technology is developing more and more than grid and cloud. So that is why it will be blur means ekuga use share ani ante vachina vache vache technology ni ippudu vache nowadays vache technology kanna grid and cloud anedi very important topic but ippudu technology anedi inka improve avuta undi so grid and cloud lo kanna inka ekuga improve avutundi kabatti future lo ee two technologies anedi takkuga use chese chances undi so it means they are saying the boundary between grid and clouds are getting blurred in recent years for web services workflow for web services workflow technologies are used to coordinate or orchestrate service with certain specification used to define a critical business process model such as two phase transactions okay na two phase transactions in generally in a grid system applies static resource while a cloud emphasizes the elastic resource so grid and cloud means what is that we are differentiating this grid and cloud grid means what grid anedi static resources grid lo static resources untai and cloud lo manaki elastic resources untai okay na so static resources elastic resources so the example of this so here we are using the in this approach we are used in workflow the BPEL is the web service standard and several important workflow approaches including Pegasus and Trident and Shift in all approaches one is building a collection of services which together and a part of distributed computing problem so in the grid server we are going to discuss about the grid versus cloud ma grid ki cloud ki difference enti so grid ki grid and cloud gurinchi ekkuga manam discuss chesthe recent years lo manaki din gurinchi ekkuga anedi utilize cheyaledu ante it will be say it is getting very blurred in the recent years so the web services workflow technologies are used to coordinate the services with certain specific used to define critical business process models such as transactions two phase transactions so in this we are using the BPEL web service standard and several important workflow approaches used in workflow okay so this is the difference of versus of grid and cloud okay next we are going to discuss about introduction to grid architecture and standards grid computing now coming to the grid computing so what is meant by grid computing so grid computing system okay so now coming to the grid computing system so coming to grid computing a grid computing is a distributed coming to the grid computing ma so in a grid introduction to grid architecture and standards so okay so grid computing system so a grid computing grid computing is a form of distributed computing whereby super and virtual computer is composed of a cluster of networked loosely coupled computers acting in a concern to perform very large task so grid computing is smart one in this grid computing is nothing but it is a distributed computing so in this we are having super and virtual computers it is composed of cluster of network So it is loosely coupled computers acting to concern to perform a large task. So grid computing అనేది large task ని perform చేయడానికి perform చేస్తుంది. It will be enacting to perform a very large task. So in this we are having the super and virtual computers that will be distributed in nature. So grid computing is a distributed in nature. So in this we are having the super and virtual computers in order to perform a very large complex task. So that is the grid system. Grid computing is a growing technology that facilitates the executions of large scale resource and intensive applications on geographically distributed computing resources. So computing technology anedi grid computing technology anedi ekkuga developing technology anedi ekkuga growing anedi jarugutu undi. So that facilitates the execution of large scale resources. So it means in the grid technology, whenever the technology is improving, so it is trying to execute the large scale resources and intensive applications of the geographical distributed in nature. Geographical distributed in nature ante entma, so everyone is going to utilize. So grid can be everyone can going to utilize that grid. It is a geographically distributed computing resource and facilitates flexible, secure, coordinated large scale resources sharing among dynamic collections of individuals, institutions and resources. So these are the things we are going to done in the grid computing. So flexible ga untundi, security anedi untundi. Security compared to the cloud, grid lo anta ekku security undadma, chana less security anedi untundi, but compared to the grid, compared to the cloud, it is less in the grid computing. So large scale resources ni share chestundi and large tasks ni evaluate chestundi and dynamic collections of individuals, institutions and resources, these are be occurred in this grid computing. So communities enable computer virtual organization to stay geographical distributed resources as they pursue common goals. So okay, so this is called the grid computing. In this grid computing, whatever the services or we have the service oriented, flexible, seamless sharing of heterogeneous network of resources for compute intensive and data intensive tasks to provide the faster throughput and scalability at lower cost. So whenever grid computing lo manam work anedi faster gaane untundi, whatever the task we are evaluating, that will be very fast and according to the cost it will be low. Okay na, so the ability of share resources across geographically makes the grid really attractive. So geographical means what ma? So in the through the grid dwara man geographical ante endi, wherever you go you can share the resources. So that is very really attractive. The grid provides virtualization of heterogeneous results that give the better management of resources. So this is called the grid computing system. So overall ga few points lo cheppalante, grid anedi distributed in nature. So grid anedi manam grid dwara manam large task ni manam evaluate chestam, large task ni perform chestam. Okay na, so indulo manaki em untayma, super computer and virtuals virtuals untai. Okay na, super computer and virtual super and virtual computers untai. So through that we are going to perform a large complex tasks. Okay na, so that is the overall. So it will be geographically share the resources. So it is very really attractive and this is called the grid computing system. Okay na, next coming to criteria for a grid. So before going to criteria of the grid, so if you see the here, computational grid is a hardware and software. Computational grid is a hardware and software infrastructure. Computational grid is a hardware and software infrastructure. Okay, infrastructure that provides the dependable consistence pervasive and inexpensive access to high end of computational capabilities. Okay, so a grid is a type of parallel and distributed system that enables for sharing the autonomous resources dynamically, ensuring the user's quality of service. Okay, so grid computing has the known as number of other names, such as grid computing ki so many names unnai. Okada chi grid ani call cheyachu, computational grid anachu, computing on demand anachu, on demand computing. So these are the different names we are calling for the grid. So okay na. So this is the goals, this is the goals of the grid computing, okay na. So we will discuss in the next class, ma. Hello your students. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I take in the next class, ma? So I'm stopping from here. This is the goals. So these goals will be explained in the next class, because other madam is waiting for this system. So we don't have more systems in present in the college. So okay, ma.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, ma.